12 cat owners were asked, what color is your cat? Is it gray, brown, white, or black? They made a first draft of a bar graph, and that's what we're looking at. One axis on the graph shows the number of cats. The other axis tells us if they're gray, brown, white, or black. And now we can compare each group of cats there, like the fact that there are two more gray cats than black. On a bar graph, the data there can be put together, taken apart, or compared. Picture graphs can show the same data you see, except with pictures and a key. The safari guide was asked, where are the most giraffes? In the water, by the trees, or on the grass? He drew them up a draft of a picture graph, and that's what we're looking at. One axis on the graph shows the number of giraffes. The other tells us if they're in the water, by the trees, or on the grass. And now we can compare all the tall giraffes there, and see there's one giraffe more by the trees than on the grass. On a bar graph, the data there can be put together, taken apart, or compared. Picture graphs can show the same data you see, except with pictures and a key.
Let's look at a bar graph showing all of the giraffes in the water, by the trees, or on the grass. And see that every time we craft any type of bar graph, we label the axes and write a title on each draft. And it shows us that in all, 10 giraffes are standing tall on a warm summer day in Senegal, roaming the plains by calm seas, eating fruits, flowers, and leaves from different species of acacia trees.
On a bar graph, the data there can be put together, taken apart, or compared. Picture graphs can show the same data you see, except with pictures and a key.